नमस्ते वन एंड ऑल। आई प्रोफेसर प्रसाद प्रभाकर कुलकर्णी स्टैंड हियर टू इंट्रोड्यूस टुडेज रिसोर्स पर्सन मिस्टर सौरभ केरहलकर। आई एम वेरी ग्लैड टू से दैट ही बिलोंग्स टू आवर फैटर्निटी, दैट इज इंजीनियरिंग फैटर्निटी। ही डीड हिज बैचलर ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम नॉर्थ महाराष्ट्र यूनिवर्सिटी इन 2007। He did his short-term industrial stint with EMCO Industrial Transformers Private Limited, Thane, as a design engineer. Later on, he worked with Praj Industries Limited, Pune, till 2015 and exited as associate manager for manufacturing delivery. Meanwhile, he upgraded with Master of Production Engineering from Pune University. He is also trained professional in import-export management. He is a practicing exporter. He is a member of various associations and organizations like American Society of Quality, Lean Six Sigma Black Belt Professional, Indian Society for Training and Development, Indian Society for Technical Education, DGFT, Maharashtra Chambers of Commerce, and FIO. Then, in 2015, he started his venture as Supran Services, particularly in quality and manufacturing consultancy, which additionally was focusing on training, printing, and data entry services also. In 2018, he expanded his brand as Supran Global Trades, centered mostly on domestic trade, sales and marketing, digital marketing and portfolio management. At this moment, his team has a presence in Gulf region for agri and FMCG product exports. So I am very much fortunate to have a versatile resource person, a young entrepreneur and a smart businessman as a resource person for today's session. So I request Shri Saurabh Keralkar to start his session. Thank you.
Hello everyone, good morning. Myself Saurabh. Today we are going to discuss the topic as global trade and international marketing. Prior step towards your journey to make in India. It is a prior step as we must have the survey. In our previous lecture we have discussed that we must have the market survey, we must have the market understanding, particularly the understanding of the global trade. And we have gone through various tools. Like trade map, then CBIC, then we have also seen that various export promotion councils available for the promotion of exports in India. So around 40 plus EPCs, that is export promotion councils, are available for export promotion in India. So that we have seen. So today we are going to see the actual case study of implementation of all these tools and which are the parameters we must think as a step towards your journey to make in India. So first we would discuss a little about product selection and the current country selection, as well we must discuss that how our product should be, that it must be repeatable, it must be sellable, we can scale up our market, and we must add the value into our product. So in our previous lecture we have discussed that yes, we have to inculcate more and more quality into our product so that it will be easily acceptable into domestic as well as the global market. And very rarely we'll have to give the emotional call to boycott the other country's product. So the best way to prefer sale of our product is to improve the quality of product. So of course, how to make that is the later part. But in my lecture today, we are going to discuss that how we are going to select the country and how we are going to select the product as a initial market survey to jump onto the conclusion of selection of the product. So one more thing we have to check is that my product offering better, faster and cheaper services. So whenever I say better, of course the quality must be there. Faster means, are we producing it on a faster rate, or are we matching the customer buying rate, or are we fulfilling the customer demand? And cheaper, of course, the most important parameter is the cost. So all these things we are going to discuss through one case study today. And few of you might complain that I'm just discussing simple examples like onion or grape. Today also I'm going to have the one of the simplest food sector case study. But yes, the exercise is for you. You have to conduct that survey. I have already explained you various tools. So that product survey you have to conduct, that product analysis and the country selection you have to do. You have to go for various engineering products. So that exercise is for you post these sessions. And of course, I'm there for any of your doubt. So we will start with the product selection and country selection. So product selection. So to select the product, we must first understand that whether there is a need in market and am I creating alternative to the import. Whenever I say that am I creating alternative to import, then we must check which are the list of products. We must check the list of products India is importing from the other countries. So the job is very easy for you. We have to just get the list of products which India is importing, and that we have to think of, that we have to analyze that whether those products are right, whether are we capable of manufacturing them, and that we have to start manufacturing in India. So that's the simple formula for you, that we have to check out the list of the products which we are importing from other countries, and that too particularly from China, because we have seen that 60% of the export orientation is from China, and the overall global contribution in exports is around 15% by China. So we have to just think of the list of a list of items which we are importing from China. So product selection, as we have discussed, that we have to go for the CVIC site. So let me share my screen. So hopefully you can see my screen now. So I have already discussed that we have to go into customs, then tariff, then we'll go to various sections and the chapters to understand the HS code. So let us say today I'm, for a case study, I'm selecting chapter number 9, which shows that coffee, tea, mint and spices. So section 9 I am selecting for today's case study. So in that we can go with the various things, that coffee, then tea is there, various sort of composition, various sort of quality ratings have been given, then the contents, then even you can see that green tea is there. Then yes, so my focus today is on to spices. So why spices? That I have selected because tea and coffee, I can understand that it is already well produced in India and it is having a lot of competition. So just to get out of the competition, I'll focus on any other part rather than focusing on tea and coffee, just for the coming out of the competition. And since already there are many players into market in Indian market, so I'll focus of the other than the tea and coffee products. So let us say I'm checking any other, I'm glancing, I'm going through the list. So here you can see ginger, turmeric. So there are, so I'll just check out anything else than this. So I'm thinking, can I get? Yeah, so you can see that this one vanilla, this product today I'm going to have the survey. I'm selecting this vanilla product for the market survey. So whenever I'm asking anyone that what is vanilla, so the first and easiest answer is that it is the ice cream, or it is the flavor of food products, or it is most of the cake or the flavor or the ice cream. But here we can see that it is a spice. So my first step, so friends, you have to note down the steps which I am following as I am practicing exporter, and I am following few steps which I actually use in practice to select my products and countries. So first step of selection of any product is that I have to check onto trusted resourcing websites. So for me, I'm using Wikipedia, and onto Wikipedia I'm searching vanilla. Why Wikipedia? Because the first step of product selection is that know my product. What exactly my product is, where it is produced, where is the origination, where it is the hierarchy and the chronology of its history, then method of production. So this all the things you get onto the trusted websites. So first step is to increase our knowledge about the product. Once we are increasing our knowledge about product, then we will actually jump on to conclusion that whether I can take this product for manufacturing, whether I can consider this product for Make in India or not. So let us say if I'm going for vanilla, so I'll just go with the history and I'll come to know that it is a type of Bourbon vanilla, and the type is another type is Madagascar vanilla. So I have to just also check that where its origination is. So in Wikipedia you can see that now vanilla flower is there. So in a raw form it is a cultivated plant, and it is a flower type of flowering plant. So further I am moving, so I am just checking history of this. So I'm again moving it bit ahead. I'm checking the cultivation. I'm just glancing through this. So I can see over here that I can understand the application of it. So here the application is given that it is widely used in commercial and domestic baking, perfume, and aromatherapy. So here I can understand its application also. Then I can understand where it is produced actually. So here you can understand that Madagascar, it is producing, then neighboring island like some of the southwestern of Indian Ocean, Indonesia, and Indonesia's. So Indonesia is producing 2/3 of world supply of vanilla. Okay, and also we can understand the value of the product. That here you can see that vanilla is the second most expensive spice after saffron. So saffron is the kesar spice. So the price of saffron sometimes ranges beyond 60,000 per kg, 60,000 rupees per kg, and the vanilla cost somewhere 48,000 to 50,000 rupees per kg. So of course the value is there, since the applications we have seen, it is repeatable in nature, it can be scaled up, and various related ancillaries and various relevant products can be generated from vanilla. So today's case study is vanilla. So I'm going a bit ahead. So I can see that the byproducts of this vanilla, that is vanilla extract, is there. Then I can see the preparation, type of stock, how to be done. So where are the harvesting? What are the drying conditioning? So we can understand here we can see that how it is packed. And the composition and specification of this, the gradation of the product. So grade A, grade 1, grade B. So how much sizing should be there, how much weight should be there, how much moisture content should be there. So here we can understand. So friends, just by going through the trusted website, we can understand much of the information about the product. So here you can see that vanilla production for 2018 So Madagascar was the highest producer of the vanilla in world. So friends, here we have understood a little about the product. So what is the further step? Once I have understood the product, what is the further step? I have to check for the trademark. So I am going for the product. So using the site trademap.org. So I am checking the vanilla over here. So I am checking with vanilla neither crushed nor ground. And I am going for trade indicator. So list of importers for the selected product in 2019. So here we can understand that USA, France, Germany, Canada, Japan are the first top five, are the top five market countries for the vanilla. So here we can understand the market, importing market for vanilla. Similarly, we can check the exporting market for vanilla, which are the exporting countries for vanilla. So you can see that Madagascar, Indonesia, France, Canada, Germany. So friends, we cannot see India in top 10. So India is not in top 10 supplying market. So of course, there is some opportunity for India for this product. So this is my initial understanding. So as we have seen that in Wikipedia that Madagascar, Indonesia and some of the southwestern Indian countries can southwestern Indian states can produce are producing the vanilla. So our research is backed by this statistics that see you can see that Madagascar, Indonesia, France and Canada, these three are the countries where we can see that they are on top of the exporting market. So that and same thing we have seen into the Wikipedia also that Madagascar and Indonesia are the producers of the vanilla. So now coming on to the another part, that is India somewhere involved into this or not? So we can check, we will select India and we'll wait for the results. So list of importing markets for the product exported by India in 2019. So here we can see that India has only supplied it to USA. Since the USA is the topmost importer, there is some contribution by India in which India is supplying vanilla to USA. So this product, let us go that somewhere in India, there is suppliers of vanilla. So I'll go to Google, I'll just check. Vanilla production in India. So here I can see that in India, vanilla cultivation is gaining in Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu since 1990s. So now I can understand that if I want to just trade the vanilla, so for me the suppliers will be available at South Indian states. Simultaneously, I can go to spice board where I can see the Indian vanilla information. So friends, here we can see that all the description and the area area wise production for Indian market, it is already shown into this. So I'm not actually thinking of producing the vanilla, but I'm just thinking of trading or manufacturing the byproducts of vanilla, or rather the relevant products, or just like the extracts of vanilla, so that I can start manufacturing. So once I am getting the proper information, so now I'll again go to the trade map and I'll check out what are the importing aspects of India. So friends, here we can see that list of supplying markets for the product imported by India. So here we can see that UAE, Indonesia and Belgium. So particularly we are importing it from. So there is very much less import, you can see that there is a trade balance in negative. So that means there is very less import is there, and hence India is actually satisfying the need of vanilla in-house only. So this is my first understanding. So now I'll go again into the vanilla and I'll check the what are the all country markets. So I'm going for trade indicators. So now my country selection part is done, but I can see which are my top three markets which are importing vanilla. So I can see USA, France, and Germany are my top three markets. But just to have the entry level, so I cannot start with these three countries because already competition would be very high. All the exporters would be thinking to supply the products to these three countries. Hence, I would be focusing any other market. So I can see that there is some potential with Netherlands. I can see there is potential with Canada, fourth country. Then Netherlands is there. Then I can check out with. So here I can understand that USA is my target market. And Netherlands and other countries are my. So somewhere seventh and eighth countries are my seventh, eighth, or fifth to tenth ranking are the good countries or the potential country market wherein I can start my business rather than jumping into completely competitive market. So here I get the top three or top 10 countries for my product. Similarly, I have to check the growth, the annual growth of value. So here we can see that if I'm just comparing with the Netherlands, so I can see that there is not a incremental growth. So I have to select such countries whereas incremental growth is there. So I can check out that there is a growth with, let us say, annual growth. I can say yes, 24% is the annual growth between 2015 to 2019. So yes, Netherlands I can select. Similarly, I can see that there is a growth with Denmark also, 14% growth is there. And we can even compare the costing also. So here the quantity of unit is given in tons and the pricing is given in unit US dollars per unit. So once we are dividing this per unit value, this unit value divided by tons, so we can get the per kg cost in dollars, US dollars. So that way we are getting the initial idea of the pricing of the product also by using this trade map. So friends, I think you are clear with how to select the countries, how to select the target market, and how to select the potential market. So that we have seen. So now I am clear with the product selection, that why I have chosen vanilla, because there is very less scope of export from India to other countries for vanilla. We have seen that also, that statistics also. Simultaneously, the pricing of the product is good and the application is also good because all the bakery, all the food sector companies, then all the aroma related companies will be requiring the raw material as vanilla. So let's go to next segment now, where I can get the buyers for this. So how can I get the buyers for vanilla? If I'm trading the vanilla, how I'm going to get the market for this? So just let us go to the application of this. So wherein we can, so we have to go for the micro level of planning for the potential buyers or potential application of vanilla. So first industry, we can say that bakery. Then second, we can say the aroma industry. Third, we can go with the medical and pharmaceutical industry, pharma industry, because we can understand that for kids, they will be very, very resistant to take the medicines in the normal form, in a normal bitter taste. we have to give these some of the flavors to their medicines. So of course the vanilla is one of the flavor which kids will like. So pharma industry, then the nutrition, we can say that life nutrition and segment, then food segment like ice cream and all. Similarly, the since this is a very rich sort of spice, so it will be used by the five star and premium level segment hotels. Can be used with we can say it can be used in some of the paper industries. The flavor, the aroma based papers, then we can think that it can be used for extract, as an extract. It can be used as the oil. We can extract the oil for some medicinal purpose. So already it is covered, let us say, into the pharma and medicinal use. So it can be used in external application like cosmetics. So now once we are clear with these applications, so friends, we have to understand, we have to have the knowledge of our product. So first step is the know my product. Second is the know my customer. So through Wikipedia, I have understood the product information. So by application, I have understood the who is going to be end user of my product. By trade map, I have understood which are the potential countries, potential global markets for my product. So now I have enlisted the applications of the product, and I have now I have selected few of the countries. So let us say I am selecting Netherlands and Australia as potential buyers. So now I have to go for searching all these application based industries into my selected countries. So I am not going much deep into that, but I am just giving you direction that how you will search these application based companies into my selected countries. So if I am just creating the sales oriented pipeline, so suppose I am considering the bakery oriented businesses, top 10 companies in Australia and Netherlands. So 10 companies for Australia and 10 companies for Netherlands. So I am getting my 20 potential leads. So similarly, I am creating 20 potential leads in this segment also. Similarly, I am creating 20 potential leads in this segment also. So I am having 9 applications and 2 countries. So I am almost creating around 180 leads as an importing market. So we have to understand that I'm repeating again that know my product, know my customer, know my market. These are the three steps to jump onto conclusion, because merely we cannot directly jump onto manufacturing, since manufacturing is a process oriented thing, and a lot of steps are involved, lot of investment is there, lot of resourcing is there. So we must have our market survey done properly first, then only we will think of the project for Make in India. So I think you have understood till now. So further we will move towards understanding the various aspects, various how to pitch in my product, how to compare it with the available market suppliers. So I'm just going through Alibaba.com. So now going through the current scenario, you may say that, sir, Alibaba is the Chinese based platform. So I think yes, it is Chinese based platform. As I already said that if we are directly boycotting the products from China or any of its platform, then we are bound by various international trade laws, and we cannot do that directly. So best way is that use those potentials, use those resources up to the extent that up to the full potential that we are promoting our products. So let the platform be of any other country, but it must be used for selling our products or the products made in India. So that we must be smart enough to use various platforms. And one more general understanding and thumb rule is that if we are going into market as a seller directly, so no other competitor will give you the idea about the market. So you have to present yourself as a buyer, you have to present yourself as a customer, you have to grab the information cleverly from the market, and then you will be creating yourself as a seller or supplier. So that you have to make clear into your mind that we cannot compete into the market directly by isolating from various platforms or various tools. We have to use those tools and platforms. Let that be from China, let that be from Pakistan, but as a manufacturer or as a businessman, our focus must be completely on getting the market, no matter which tool and which platform we are using. So I'm using the Alibaba platform now, and I'm just searching the vanilla now. So friends, here we are getting the current prices, current market suppliers, how the packaging should be. So here you can understand that there are so many suppliers, and these suppliers are also our buyers. This can be our buyers. How that I am going to tell you. Suppose one renowned supplier is getting a bigger order or the high quantum or high volume order from any of the buyer. So he cannot fulfill that order by his own. So he would be requiring sub vendors or sub suppliers or subcontractors. So there the opportunity is created for us. So don't consider that everyone presenting here or everyone registering themselves as a buyer cannot be our potential customer. Of course, they will also be our potential customer in future. So so that's why I'm telling friends that we must be smart traders first, and then we have to think of the manufacturing of the products by our own. Because once we are establishing our market, of course our products will be sold. So we have to make it clear. We have to make sure that we are having our market fix. Then only we will go for the manufacturing of products. Then we will not be landing up into any of the other liabilities which generally manufacturing segment is facing nowadays. So here we can see that various suppliers are there. We have to see their websites also. We can go into the products. We can check how is the packing of the product. So here we can see that how they are actually giving the orders. So friends, if we are approaching these suppliers as a buyer, so they will be giving us the quotations, they will be giving us the rough invoices, and those rough invoices or the quotations will be our base to create the quotation for our buyer. So understand that somewhere we are not violating the basic rules that our product must be better, faster and cheaper. And cheaper is the first parameter to select the product. So hence we can see now that now we can understand that what is the specification. So vanilla beans, which tire, dried, weight, place of origin, some what sort of packing. So your confusion will be removed now that how it is packed. So either it is packed in carton or it is packed in tube or plastic sachets. So here we can understand. So how it is delivered. So what sort of packaging 1 kg is required? How much is the length, width and height of the packaging? So friends, here you can understand. There is some video are also shared through the supplier. Here you can see that the plastic vacuum plastic bag packaging is supplied. How much is the size of the bean? How the images has to be shared? How see how they are producing? How it is originated? It is hand-picked and hand-sorted. So this way you get the product information. You can see the site of the supplier. And it will give you the guideline of how to create our own website, how to register ourselves as a supplier onto one platform. So friends, I think I have given you the most of the information about how to see the competitors, how to understand how to select the product, how to select the market, how to go for the survey of the country selection, how to collect the basic information about my product. So this is just the what I can say, this is just the overview for you, and this way you can actually create your own platform. This way you can create your own tools. There are so many businesses coming out of this. You can become manufacturer, you can become trader, you can become supplier. So now just this is the beginning, and now we can see that various products, once we are jumping onto one product, we can see various products from this. So we can say the vanilla extract, you can see vanilla extract just through Google also. We can if we are simultaneously, if I'm just going through Google, I can check out that. So vanilla products, whether it is, sorry, I can just go with the images also. See that. How many products are there? So some vanilla extracts are there, vanilla perfumes are there, vanilla oils are there. You can see vanilla ice cream flavoring agents are there. There is organic vanilla is there. So friends, we can go with the in-depth survey, in-depth analysis of our product. So even one application we forgot to write, that is beveraging industries, that alcohol industries. So that is also drinks and beverage industry. This is also an application. So now our, instead of 180 leads, we are creating 200 leads. If you are just checking the 10 companies per country, and if I have selected two countries as my potential market. So this search I can give onto Google or onto the relevant country, relevant search engine. So that way I can do. I can check it onto B2B websites like Alibaba.com. I can just check it onto Amazon also. So you can understand, friends, that there are multiple sources just present online, wherein you can complete your online survey of your products, wherein you can complete the understanding of the product selection, market selection. Here you can see one of the product is there, which is about the supplements and nutritions. You can see nowadays many of the people are going for gymming and having the supplements, protein supplements. So as a flavoring agent into those supplements, vanilla can be used. So this is just one example for your understanding. This is just one idea orientation for you, that how to jump onto one product. So we have selected, we have gone through CBIC first, then we have checked it onto Wikipedia, then we have checked it into Trademap, then we have seen the comparative analysis onto Alibaba.com. So likewise, you can compare the various pricings, various suppliers. See, here also another supplier is there. So organic supplier, organic wholesale supplier for Madagascar Bourbon Vanilla. So here you can understand what is the color of the product, what are the specification, which are the specification the buyer will be asking when I'm presenting my product. So which application he is, so here you can see that packing he has given on to buyer's choice. So this is also possible. We can ask customer that what sort of packaging you want. Here you can see that he is focusing more onto the medical application. Hence he has mentioned that organic vanilla. So onto this he has given some sort of information sharing with clients also, because in today's world, if you are making your client knowledgeable, so that helps him a lot, and it is creating trust into customer's mind. So I think I have just helped you a little about how to jump onto the comparative analysis, how to go with the product selection, how to go with the market selection. Here you can see that vanilla powder is also there, vanilla extract powder. So friends, you can understand just by selecting one thread of the product, one thread of the material, how we are creating so many relevant products. So that way, the exercise I'm giving it to you, that you have to check, you have to use all these tools. You have to go onto different segmentation of CBIC. I'll again take you onto CBIC. See, I've just checked with very less in products, that one grape, onion, and now vanilla. So you have to jump onto see. You have to go to various chemical products, you have to go to various rubber and plastic articles, you can go to wood and other articles, you can use the textile based articles, you can use stone, plaster, cement based articles, you can go with the base metal articles. So just the process is that you have to first select 3 to 4 articles out of this 98 chapters I have already shared to you. This 98 chapters are there. So just to begin with, towards your Make in India initiative, what you can do is that you can just check out with the 4 to 5 segments out of these 98 chapters. You can do study onto that those 98 chapters, sorry, those 4 to 5 selected items, and then you will select one out of that. And you will jump onto the conclusion that, okay, I'll be more compatible for selection of this chapter, and I can work into this chapter. I'm having a fair idea of this relevant articles into this chapter, and that further you will study that whether market is available, which are the importing countries, which are the competitive exporting countries, which can be my potential market, which can be my target country to do the business in future. So this way you can understand the global trade. So friends, this is the basic information. Apart from this, what we can do is that we can check out the various buyer finding modes. So I'll discuss those various buyer finding modes also now with you. So how to find the international buyers. So buyer finding modes. So we can approach to Indian embassy present in the buyer country. They can share us the trade data, or they can share us the company data from that country. Simultaneously, we can attend trade exhibitions. Resourcing is that you can go with the 10times.com and you can have the registered choices of your various exhibitions, or exhibitions of your favored or the segments which you like. Let us say, suppose somebody is having the interest into the garment industry, so you can check the you can give preference as a garment industry into that 10times.com, and you can understand wherever worldwide which sort of exhibition is happening. So due to the COVID situation, I think now very less trade exhibitions are happening, but of course in future you can get the information through 10times.com. similarly, you can have the membership of EPC. So just for your understanding, that we can have the if we are the vanilla supplier, as a case study over here, we will have the membership of Spice Board of India. So through this membership also we can get the potential buyers. Similarly, we can be associated with the various manufacturers associations into that segment. We can have the association with the end user associations, like consumer forums and all. Therein we can get the data. Similarly, we can actually have the business directories of that country. Similarly, we can have the idea of the supply chain agents, just like the manufacturer, then regional distributors, then local distributor, then wholesalers and retailers. So if we are understanding this chain, we can easily crack down the buyers from this chain. And potential suppliers, as I earlier said, those can also be our buyers. Then we can have the search engine optimizations. We can have the various search engines. We have just seen various B2B search engines. So there are n number of search engines available, or the business platforms, like we have discussed that Go for World Business. Last time we have seen that. I'll again show that to you. So this Go for World Business, herein you can actually understand which are the orders available. We can check out the relevant segment buyers from this. So this way we can check. Just to take you back to the Go for World Business, here you can see that medical clothing, this order is there for mask from India itself, and this order is still active. You can join this deal. So this way you can understand that which sort of business trends are there, where actually the manufacturing scope is there. So friends, you can understand that which products and which sort of orders are there active globally. That survey you can have. So I have discussed that Indian embassies, trade exhibitions, then social media platforms, social media groups, and industries specific SMEs, and so subject matter experts, then affiliate marketing agents. So this way you can reach out to the potential buyers. Even you can think of the student communities also. So student communities also have good spread worldwide. So Indian, you know that already Indian students are spread worldwide. So that help you can take to promote your business into that country. So friends, apart from this, professional communities, so communities of engineers. So, best example is that if I'm telling you that vanilla is used into the 5-star hotels and premium segment hotels. So professional community would be that chefs associations in that country. So that you can approach them and you can promote your vanilla to them. So this is just basic understanding for you today. Hopefully you will use all these tools and you will apply these tools. You will have the market survey. You will try to identify the potential market for your product. You will try to first do the survey that whether my product is scalable in market, whether it is repeatable, whether the sales is repeatable or not. So friends, I think I have done with my basic analysis of product survey. I have shown you how to use the various tools to understand the potential buyers, potential countries. Even some of the discussion I have said to you regarding the product selection. And you can use these online tools. So friends, I wish you all the best for your Make in India journey. Hopefully my lecture would be helpful. My lecture is helpful to you and you will use all these tools. Simultaneously, you can contact me anytime whenever you feel. You can, I'll mention my number over here that mention my number over here. Anytime you can approach me if you have any case of doubt, and I again thank SIEM for giving me opportunity to interact with you. Hopefully we will be touch we will be in touch in future. Thank you so much. Wish you all the best. Thank you.
Namaste one and all. I welcome you all in this student faculty development program on Making India a Journey Towards Self-Reliance. This program is a small initiative to support the Make in India movement. Nowadays, the students are looking for jobs to start their career. But that is not only a way to start the career, but to become an entrepreneur is also one of the way to start the career. And those who have dream, those who have willpower, those who have capacity to work hard, they can become entrepreneur. But the thing is that they are not going to be aware of these things. So to make them aware, to motivate, to encourage them, we are going to share the stories of our entrepreneur students, that is our alumni, who become entrepreneur in their career, and now they are successful entrepreneur. So we are going to share some of the stories of our alumni. So we are going to begin this from today. So first name in this regard is Mr. Virat Shelar. Yesterday we have seen the story of Kartik Bansal in his own words, but now onwards we are going to tell you the story of our alumni who become successful entrepreneur in their career. So we will start with the story of Mr. Virat Shelar. He is MD of Shriraj Enterprises and Vishwajit Group of Companies. His firms are in part development, manufacturing, learning solution, SEO and digital marketing. He is also putting his footprints in IT sector. His firms are in website development, mobile application and data entry services. He is also in content and blog writing, learning solutions too. And lastly, but not the least, he is also in tourism sector. He is having his own farm resort. It is called as GVC Farm Resort. Along with the business, he is doing a lot of social work too. In this pandemic, he helped too many families a lot. So he is a person with multidimensional personality. So we all have a great pleasure to have such a versatile alumni like Mr. Virat Shelar. So we wish him all the best for his further career. So this is a little story of Virat Shelar. Thank you.